Hi, I'm Michael, an engineer on the Firebase team. Getting a public web app set up with Firebase Hosting is super simple, but we hear a lot of questions about how to bring a site to production. So today, we're going to show you a few steps for getting ready for the big launch and for managing your app once it's out in the wild. My team has been building a site called Friendly Eats. It's a restaurant review app, and we're finally about ready to launch it. But before we do, I'm going to take a few steps to make sure that my site is ready for real users. So what do we need to do? Something I've already done is create a second dev Firebase project for my app. This way, my team can test out new features without worrying about breaking our production app. I've also already upgraded my production project to the pay-as-you-go Bleigh plan. That way I know my site won't get disabled if I exceed the free quota. When I upgraded, I set a budget alert so there won't be any surprises on my monthly bill. Now we're going to change some of our production project settings to get ready for launch. We'll make it easier to see what's happening with cloud logging and better secure our project by tightening permissions. After that, we're going to automate testing and deployment of our site to make development fast and predictable. Let's get started. As you can see, I have two Firebase projects here, a production and a development project. I'm going to go into my production project and go to the hosting panel. From here, I'm going to go to usage and scroll down and see view web request logs with cloud logging. So I want to enable cloud logging so that I can see request logs for everything that my users do on my site. So I'll click here, go ahead and get started, turn it on, and that's all I have to do. So now every time a request hits my production website, I will see a request in cloud logging, which we'll come back to later. Now, I also want to review all of the users that have access to my app. So I'm going to go to settings, users and permissions. And here we have three members of my project, myself and Kay and my teammate Cam. Now Cam is currently listed as an editor, but Cam really only works on the back end. So I'm going to click on Cam, change their role and say that they are a develop admin, but they don't need access to the quality or grow, and they don't need to be able to modify permissions or anything like that. So I'll click done, update roles. Now, this is just something that is a good practice to do. Before you go live to production, you should review all of the members of your project and make sure that they have appropriate access. Now I'm going to jump over to the Google Cloud Console to restrict the permissions of the browser API key that Firebase uses to call various APIs. I'm going to navigate to APIs and services and then credentials. From there, I see that there's a browser key that was automatically created by Firebase. So I'm going to click into that and I'm going to add two types of restrictions. First, I'm going to restrict what types of websites use my API key. Then I'm going to restrict which APIs my key can call. For the websites, I'm going to add my website, which is friendlyeats.reviews. My web.app website that's associated with my Firebase project. And also the URL for my QA preview channel, which I'll be setting up in a little bit. For API restrictions, I'm going to restrict the key to only a set of Firebase APIs. So I want to select the Firebase installations, management, and remote config APIs. And I also want to select the identity toolkit API, which is what Firebase Auth uses. So now that I've restricted both the URLs and the APIs for this API key, I can save that. And now my API key is ready for production.
We're getting close to launch day, and I'm feeling pretty confident about my app's security and stability. I've completed most of my production checklist, but one big step remains. I want to automate deployment and testing of my app to make a reliable workflow my whole team can use to bring features from idea to production. To do this, we'll use Firebase Hosting Preview Channels. Channels let me deploy work-in-progress versions of my site to a temporary URL that I can share with my team. I can deploy to channels manually using the Firebase CLI, but we've also added some help to make it easy to integrate channels directly with GitHub. Let's give it a try.
I'm going to start by adding my new dev project to my local environment. The Firebase use command lets me swap between projects. You can see that right now I only have a default project, which is prod. I'm going to run Firebase use add and link my dev project as a new environment. This brings up a list of my Firebase projects, and I'll go down and select my dev project. I'll also call it dev. This writes configuration to a .firebase.rc file in my project directory. You can see I have both default and dev. I'm going to quickly rename default to prod so that I always know which environment I'm dealing with. Once I've done this, I can easily swap between projects. So I can say Firebase use dev to switch to my dev project, or I can say Firebase use prod to switch back to my prod project. I can also use a flag to do this on an individual command. So if I want to deploy to dev, I can say Firebase deploy only hosting project dev, and now it will deploy to my dev environment. This makes it easy to use multiple projects with the Firebase CLI. Now that the CLI knows how to work with all of my environments, I need to make sure that my app does too. I've created environment-specific initialization files for my local, development, and production environments. In this case, I'm just trying to make it easier to see which environment I'm in, but I could do any kind of environment-specific initialization here. To integrate these with my deploy process, I'm going to add a pre-deploy hook to my Firebase.json. This will run a list of commands before every deploy. In this case, installing dependencies and running a build script. A useful feature of the pre-deploy hook is that it provides a gcloud project environment variable for the current project to all scripts that it runs. Switching over to my package.json, I'm going to add a new env script to copy environment-specific initialization based on the gcloud project environment variable, and I'll fall back to local if it's not available. I'll then run the new env script before the build process that happens every time I run my app. Let's take a look at this in practice. I'm starting up my local dev server and will also deploy first to dev, then production environments using a project flag. Once that's done, switching over to my browser, I can see that on localhost, my local initialization script is running. On my dev environment, my dev initialization script is running. And in my prod environment, my prod initialization script is running. Being able to confidently use any of my environments without manually tinkering with settings can really speed up development. To improve the workflow for my whole team, I'm going to further automate deploys using GitHub Actions. The Firebase CLI will help me get this started step by step with the Firebase init hosting GitHub command. After authenticating with GitHub, the command asks for a repo, automatically detecting the origin remote that I'm using. Next, it fetches a service account key from my Firebase project and stores it as a secret in my GitHub repository. Because I've configured a pre-deploy script, I don't need to add an extra build step. The default flow will automatically deploy preview channels for pull requests, but I'll also have it deploy to the live version of my dev site when I merge into my dev branch. Now setup is complete, and I have two new workflows in my .github directory. One will run whenever a new PR is opened or updated in my repo, and will automatically deploy to a preview channel on my dev project. The other will run when a PR is merged and will deploy to the live channel of my dev project. To complete my workflow, I'm going to copy the deploy on merge action into another action, this time to target my production environment. When new code is merged into my main branch, this action will deploy to a QA channel in my production project for final verification before release. And now we have the complete picture. Let's jump ahead to see how this works in action. I have opened the dev version of my app, which looks pretty good, but I've been working on a redesign in preparation for launch in my local environment. There we go. This is definitely going to stand out from the crowd when we launch. Perfect, I think we're all ready to send this out. Switching back to my editor, I'm going to commit my changes in a modern branch and push them up to GitHub. To use the GitHub action I already set up, I'll need to create a pull request. Here's the branch, so I'll go ahead and create one. Creating a pull request will deploy my site to a preview channel without affecting any existing deploys. I'll make my pull request against the dev branch and send it off. Now my pull request is open, and I can see a deploy to Firebase hosting on PR action has started running. If I want to, I can click through to watch the deploy progress, but it's all happening automatically. Under the hood, the GitHub action is just running the same Firebase deploy commands I could run locally. Once the action finishes running, it will automatically post a comment with a preview URL back to the pull request.
From here, my work on the new feature is done. My teammate Kay is going to take a look and review it before it goes to production. Over to you, Kay.
Michael shared the URL of his new preview channel with me. Let's pull up this URL to see what he updated and test it out. So I'm on the preview channel now. I see Michael's update and it looks good. Note this preview channel is fully functional. If I submit a review here, then this review will get added to the database in my staging project. Let's look for that review in the Firebase console. Okay, there it is. Since the updates that Michael made look good, I'm ready to merge his PR to our staging branch. Our staging branch is connected to our Firebase staging project. When I merge Michael's PR, it automatically deploys to our staging site. So let's merge. And there it is. The updates are now on the staging site. Now, Firebase Hosting gives you the tools you need to set up your own workflow. It's flexible depending on what works for you and your team. We showed you how we've set it up, but remember, you can customize it for your own workflow. To recap our workflow, Michael and I created a website, Friendly Eats. We have a staging environment with a staging project and staging hosting site. And we have a production environment with a production project and production site. When Michael first deployed his changes, he was working in the staging project. His new PR triggered a deploy to a preview channel on the staging site. If he updates that PR, those updates are deployed to that same preview channel. That way, the URL stays consistent. After I looked at Michael's PR, I merged it to our staging branch. We set up our workflow so that when a PR is merged to the staging branch, it's automatically deployed to the staging site. At this point, things are generally looking pretty good, and I'm ready to deploy these changes to our production site. But hold on, my production site is a different environment. It's in a different Firebase project, and it has a different backend than my staging project. Even though my staging project mimics my production project, you never know what might be a little bit different. So we've set up our workflow to include a last sanity check. When I merge my staging branch into my main production branch, this kicks off an automatic deploy to a preview channel for my production site. This preview channel, which we've named QA, allows me to test out the updates with my live production backend. It's a way for the team to see the newest updates that are ready to go out to end users. Once I feel confident that what I see on the QA preview channel is exactly what I want on my live channel, which is my user-facing site, I can use the clone command to make sure it's copied over exactly. To do this, I'll run the command clone. I'm cloning from my production site's QA channel to my production site's live channel. The live channel is what my end users see and what my custom domains are linked to. Cloning, and done. Both the QA and live channel are now serving the exact same content. Remember, this is just one way to set up your workflow. We provide you with flexible tools, such as our preview channels feature and our GitHub action, so that you can set up a workflow that works for you. I also have cloud logging as a tool. When Michael set up the cloud logging integration earlier, he set up alerts, but I can check my logs at any time though, by visiting my usage for hosting here. Then I can visit the cloud logging console to filter and search for logs. If my newest update had any issues, I would see it pop up here. For example, I can filter by 404s. We just went over a bunch of features and tools for shipping production web apps with Firebase. Let's recap. Michael and I went through steps to get ready for launching our Friendly Eats site, including setting up different project environments, setting up rules, getting on the Bleigh plan, and adding cloud logging. We also went over setting up a GitHub workflow and using preview channels to share updates within our team. Let us know what you think and share how you're using Firebase.
Thanks for joining us, and we look forward to seeing all of your Firebase hosting apps in production soon. Bye!